Yes, people. Long time no Trader Joe's haul. That is because I've been busy. Busy AF, okay? So, I have gone to the stores, but why you haven't been seeing a haul is because I just never had time to film a haul. I barely had time to even go to the grocery store. So, today I have time. And I only went to Trader Joe's today, honestly, because I'm running low on my money right now, just because I'm about to get paid again next week. So, I was actually planning just to go, just to I'd like to get all my grocery done in one grocery shopping done in one day, but I was running out of vegetables, and I did have money, so. But also two people tomorrow. Okay, okay, so I was kind of like, eh, should I go to Trader Joe's? Because Trader Joe's is where I get the bulk of my stuff. That's where I get my vegetables, where I get my fruit, you know, it's like the bulk of my shopping. And then, you know, Sprouts, I get a few things, you know, the health food stores, I get a few things, but it's like mostly my main thing is Trader Joe's. So I was like, okay, I'll just go. Oh, so you know, I had a list. I make a list, and today I just kind of like, just kind of trimmed the edges. I didn't get everything on my list, and I did get a few things that weren't on my list. But people, my total, this is like the lowest total I've ever gotten. You know, when I went to Trader Joe's to get like my main stuff, this is like the lowest total ever. $52 freaking dollars, people. And I got three bags of food. So if you're thinking, I don't know about, you know, plant-based eating. It seems like it's gonna be more expensive. Girl, what? No. Mm-mm. No. It's more expensive if you get like the treat kind of things, you know, like vegan cheese, you know, vegan desserts, like special little stuff is more expensive, yeah. But the main thing, fruits, vegetables, grains, tofu, beans, is not expensive. $52 freaking dollars, people. But anyways, so and also I had some money still left over, because tomorrow I'm going to a vegan festival. I'm so excited. I haven't been to any vegan festivals. And they have them all the freaking time. I bet you wherever you live, if you go on Facebook, you know, there's, you know, the events section of Facebook, you can search, you know, vegan festival or whatever. And I bet you can find it wherever you live. Of course, you know, I live close to LA and it's like so trendy, you feel me? So it's kind of cool. But I bet you anywhere you live, you probably, you know, can find something in your area. And if not, girl, just start it yourself. That's, you know, something that I need to do for myself too. Like, it's a whole other thing. But so anyway, so I still had money left over, so I can go to the vegan festival tomorrow with my boyfriend and my best friend, and it's gonna be so fun. I'm so excited because one of the vendors there is it's this, oh my God, I'm gonna link her Instagram down below because I've talked about her before. She's this little Asian girl, okay? This tiny little Asian girl, and she has the best, people, the best vegan desserts, okay? And she has like a good portion of her desserts have no sugar in them. They're sweetened with, you know, maple syrup or brown rice syrup. So she is our girl, and she used to come to a farmer's market that my boyfriend and I used to go to, but she hasn't been there in like almost a year, and we're dying because she's moving on to bigger avenues for her business, but we're like dying without her desserts, you know? So she's gonna be at this festival. So we're gonna go and we're gonna visit her and be like, girl, we miss you. And then buy like basically all of her desserts. Stock up for the year. But anyways, it's gonna be so cool. Cool, 5 minutes and I haven't showed you anything. Okay, so let's get started. P.S. I feel like this is on a weird angle. Is it on a weird angle? I didn't know why it was like that. Still on a weird angle. Sorry, people. Professionalism. That's the Beagle Queen. So professional. Professional AF. Not. Okay. There you go. So the first thing I got from Trader Joe's, organic strawberries. Now, okay, people, you know that when you buy strawberries out of season, what's the point in buying them? Because they're sour, they're watery. It's like, why did you just waste your money? And you get so mad, right? I understand. So now it's starting to, it is springtime, and strawberries, you know, should be in season. So every time I go to Trader Joe's, I'm checking out their strawberries, being like, you know, do they look red? Do they look good? You know, because the past few times I've been, the strawberry still looks kind of like whitish green, you know, not really ripe. So I'm like, oh. So I was just thinking, like, maybe I should just go to my farmer's market. You know how they have fruit samples? But today, it looked like all their strawberries looked really good. Plus, they had organic ones, which, you know, if that's something you're concerned about, there's certain produce that is, like, more important that you get them organic than others, you know? And I think I saw a video about it, and I think what the rule generally is, like, if it's something that you eat only the inside of, like a watermelon, then it's like fine if you just get it, you know, regular or non-GMO, because you don't eat the outside where it was sprayed. You feel me? From pesticides. But, oh, also too, sorry people, also too, GMOs. So there's certain, you know, crops that they really put a lot of GMOs in, and I know that berries are one of them, strawberries included, corn, zucchini, soybeans. So, you know, I bet you can find like a complete list of all that stuff online somewhere. But yes, I was really glad that they had organic strawberries and they looked good. So I'm gonna have to wash them and taste them for myself to find out. But I'm craving strawberries, and they're finally in season. So woohoo! Okay, then I got some organic sweet onions. I don't think I ever got this variety. Maybe I did. I'm not sure. But I usually get just the yellow onions, they're called. But, I mean, I don't know. I just decided I never get these sweet onions. Maybe I'll try them. Who knows? You know, they smell good. But I use onions a lot in my cooking. If you want to make something taste good, honestly, girl, saute some onions with a little bit of oil and a little bit of salt or soy sauce, girl. Whatever you make is going to taste bomb. Onions, girl, the key emoji. Okay. Then I just, my basic vegetables is like onions, cabbage, again organic, and I like to cook this sometimes, or sometimes I eat it raw like a salad. So cabbage is a go-to because it's like versatile, you know. And speaking of versatile, okay, anyways, then I got this bag of Trader Joe's quick cook organic basmati rice. Honestly, because I like to have basmati brown rice on hand. Honestly, I just like to have a lot of grains on hand, girl. Who, let's be real, okay? Okay? I'm about that macrobiotic life. Grains, 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 grains. But I like to have the organic brown basmati rice because you know, it's better to be eating this longer grain in summertime or when it's warming up, 'cause it's slightly more yin, you know, it's more cooling. That's what, you know, this kind of rice grows in India, you know, hotter places. So the longer the grain is more yin, because yin is quality of yin is expansion. And another quality of yin is cooling. So this grows in hotter environments so that it can cool down the people that live there. Check it out. And plus it was cool that it was organic, you know? And yeah. Plus it's brown rice. Cool. Oh, another staple vegetable, carrots. And I just got the just regular, you know, plain orange ones, organic, because you know, today I was trying to like be careful, more careful with my money. And these are 79 cents. Tell me, being vegan is expensive, girl. 79 cents, girl. Okay. And it's a staple. The carrots of many colors. I usually like to get those just because it's like different colors. You know, it's cool. It makes your food look more interesting and colorful. But those I think are a dollar something. Maybe it's even a whole dollar more expensive, which is not even expensive, but I'm trying to cut corners today. So I got those ones. And then I just got a jar of organic marinara sauce for when I, you know, want to be cooking pasta with, you know, tomato sauce. And again, you know, you're into macrobiotics, you know, you're not really supposed to be eating tomatoes, but. But, you know, once in a while, if you're in good health, it's fine. Especially, you know, when it's warmer, because tomatoes are more yin. And it's like, you know, I even read in one of the books, one of the macrobiotic books, it said, you know, as the climate, you know, changes, you know, our earth, you know, the temperature is going to rise. These books were written in the 60s, 70s, 80s. They already were hip to what was going to happen, you know, in the future, but because it was already starting, and but they caught it like this, and now more people are catching on. But anyways, because the spiral is spinning faster. Okay, anyways, read the books. But anyways, it said, you know, as the climate, you know, gets hotter, things that are usually not, you know, recommended in a macrobiotic diet are going to become more acceptable as, you know, things shift, because you have to adjust. You know, that's what you know, the whole macrobiotic mentality and lifestyle is. It's like, this is the ideal way, but in case of this, then you can do this. So no matter what happens in your life, in the world, you know how to take care of yourself in the best way, and you're gonna struggle a lot less. That's why knowing this knowledge is so valuable, and that's why I share it with people. So we can all feel great, and we can all live our best life, and then the world will be peaceful in like 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 years. Okay, long before, long, we'll be long gone by then, girl, but. You know, good karma. Okay, anyways, then I got organic multi-grain hot cereal, 100% whole grain, rye, barley, oats, and wheat. And this is my go-to, you know, hot grain cereal. I've been really into oatmeal again lately. But you guys remember, I was really into making my oatmeal with like maple syrup and cinnamon and vanilla extract. And while I still think that is bomb, it's like, it's delicious. It's honestly, I would eat it like a snack, a dessert, a breakfast. But I started to have issues with my stomach because it was too yin for me. So in the beginning, you know, when you're first starting out, or you eat just like a, you know, regular American diet, if you eat that kind of thing, it doesn't really affect you. It's actually better for you than a lot of other things that you are eating or that you have been eating. But as time goes on and you fine-tune your balance, you know, things different things start to affect you differently. So it's like the better balance you become, certain things are going to start to disrupt your balance. It's like in the beginning, that was fine. It was actually better for you. But then now, when my balance is starting to get better, it's actually disrupting my balance. So I had to stop doing that. And then I kind of just stopped eating oatmeal, and that's when I started to eat the peanut butter and the tortillas every day. Honestly, I think that's the main thing that made me gain weight, because I was eating that every day. And I didn't just eat, oh, a tablespoon. No, I would just be like, with the nut butter. But anyways, so I started to get into just plain oatmeal, because one day I just woke up and I was just like, I want to eat some plain oatmeal. That's what my intuition was telling me. My body was telling me, it's just plain oatmeal. That's what I like now. Girl, what? My boyfriend is like even laughing at me. Like, he's like, poor Michelle, she's on the plain oatmeal diet. I'm like, no, that's what I wanted to eat. He's like, and he's been macrobiotic for 50 years, people. And he said, and he's looking at me like, oh, poor Michelle. It's good, okay? That's what I wanted. Anyways, so. It's fine. It's not, don't feel bad for me. I like it. Whatever. All right, people. Sorry about that. We're dog sitting this giant obnoxious dog again. So I had to close my door. But anyway, so next thing I was going to show you was organic unfiltered apple juice. And if you've been watching my recipe videos, you know I make a fizzy kind of drink with apple juice and fizzy water. And it's great. And it's a great refreshment. It's not something most macro people would approve of, but you know, It's better for you than soda. It's better for you than alcohol. So, you know. But anyways, then this I found today. It looked cool. It was next to, they had a display of this with the boxed falafel mix, which I got last time. I didn't show it to you guys. But I got it, and it's been all over Instagram. You know, people have been talking about it. So I got it, but I haven't made it yet. And anyway, so they're like basically, you know, advising that you eat this with the falafel. And it's the Girardinara? I don't even know. Some kind of thing. Slightly spicy pickled vegetables. Cauliflower, peppers, carrots, and cucumbers. This is kind of like, if you guys remember, Trader Joe's used to sell in by the sauerkraut in the refrigerated section. They used to sell like pickled jalapeno vegetables, and it was the same kind of thing. It was cauliflower, carrots, and I don't remember what else. Peppers, maybe. It was basically the same thing, but I think this is more like supposed to be like Mediterranean or something. So I got this, and also too, you know, eating like pickled kind of things, you know, fermented things is really good for your, you know, gut bacteria, you know, and that helps you in many different ways. You can just research yourself, but so I just got this. Plus, it tastes cool. It's a different taste, you know. Then I got some more tofu, organic, extra firm, sprouted tofu. And I like to get this kind that's separated, because sometimes lately I've been really into tofu, but sometimes I don't eat all of the tofu at once, or I don't make all of the tofu at once. So if you get the kind that's like a big square in the package, and then this has probably happened to you guys, and you cut like a piece of it off, and then you don't use it for a while, then it starts to go bad really fast. And then it's like, you wasted it. So I like to get it in this container, because it's like separated. So it's like, you know, portioned, you know. So, and I only cook for myself. And sometimes I also give some to Minnie, because Minnie really likes tofu. And also, I have this book. I put it somewhere else, I think. But it's Natural Healing for Pets. And it's basically a macrobiotic approach to you know, helping animals, like, is written by a veterinarian that is macrobiotic, and he grew up on a farm, and this was like not current day farm, like 50 years ago farm, so it was not as crazy. It was a, you know, small family farm. And you know, it was a lot of wisdom, you know, in that book, very, very insightful. And he said, you know, it's just basically like what animals eat is what humans eat, but it's just like a different ratio, you know, every animal is different, you know. But the same kind of thing applies, you know, tofu is more cooling, is more yin, you know. So if you have like a really crazy dog that's like, or a really aggressive dog, or, you know, it's a really hot day or something like that, you know, a little bit of tofu will cool the dog down and won't be as aggressive, you know, it will be better able to handle the heat, you know. So it's just funny, Minnie really likes tofu. Like one time I had my plate out and I, you know, wasn't really watching her. She was eating the tofu. She ate all of it. So now every time I make tofu, I save a little bit for her because she likes it. So Minnie's macro too, okay? She is. Anyways, she still eats meat and stuff, you know, but it's just, you know, here and there, different. Anyways, then I got these. These are my favorite tortillas, the corn and wheat tortillas. They aren't organic, but they are non-GMO because they're the Trader Joe's brand. And everything, if it's the Trader Joe's brand, then it's non-GMO. Everything is non-GMO, but anyways, yeah, I really like them. To make tacos, I've been really into tacos lately. I haven't been doing the nut butter tacos, you know, anymore because it's just like, you know, I did gain some weight and I'm trying to like watch it, but I've been making tacos. And then I got organic reduced fat coconut milk. And I got this because, listen, people, at Trader Joe's, they have so, I think it's new, they got so many like different curries and like Indian like simmer sauces. And I got one, it was a green one, and it was so good, but I think it had sugar in it. And then all the other ones, I was looking at the ingredients, they all had milk in there or cream or sugar or both. And I know there's probably, you know, tons of vegan curry sauce recipes. I just need to like look at one and try it. So I know that, you know, if you're going to make like a vegan curry thing, you know, you use coconut milk in place of, you know, regular milk or cream. And I got the reduced fat just because, I mean, I wasn't really sure, but I just figured it's coconut milk. It might have some coconut oil in there. And what is your girl trying to reduce oil consumption? So I don't know. I mean, if anybody knows about that kind of thing, you could just let me know. But I just thought, you know, be safe. I always like to be safe. Okay, then I got this Mediterranean hummus. This is the kind that has like, you can't really see. It has like the pine nuts and the oil. Oops, sorry. And the oregano and like red peppers in there. This hummus has been around since I was in high school. I remember when I was, when I went to a ballet summer intensive, two of the girls in my class, they were sisters, and their mom was a nutritionist, and they would always have the most like healthiest lunches. And I remember the girl was like, "Oh, my mom got the Mediterranean hummus," and she's like, "It's better when you first buy it because all the stuff is on top and it's so good." I just remember, and so I got it, you know, because I was like, I want a different hummus this time, so I got that one. Good times, old times. And then I got, this is like my new favorite grain, is polenta, organic polenta. This is amazing. I need to do a recipe video of how I make this, and it's so good. So good, so good. I mean, I bet you there's other ways you can make it too. I just made up this way and I really like it. But it's basically like a mushy kind of cornmeal. It's like watery. I don't know. They use it a lot in Italian cooking, but I mean, you can do whatever you want with it, girl. And yeah, it's just really good. I really like it. I just really like corn, okay? I like corny shit, okay? I like 50s music. I like 50s movies, you know? It's a joke. Anyways, non-GMO organic corny shit. That's what I like, okay? But anyways. And then I got some organic avocados because people just been posting a lot of like avocado toast and different avocado stuff, and I haven't eaten avocados in a long time. So I was like, let me just buy some, and I wanted to get bread so I can make like avocado toast, but I really should not be eating bread. Oh, I'll link that video down below about why I can't eat bread. But anyways, but I thought if I make tacos, I could put the avocado in the tacos. So there you go. There you go, girl. Oh, and I just had an idea. I could make the polenta and put avocado on top of the polenta. See, girl? You know, there's always a way to do it. Just gotta be creative. And also, too, avocados are more yin. Again, talking about yin and yang and the environment and all that stuff. So generally, you know, avocados, you know, in this lifestyle, you know, try to avoid them because they are more yin. But again, it's getting hotter outside, you know, it's more acceptable, you know. It's just not like every day, you know, once in a while is more acceptable, you know. Oh, speaking of more yin stuff, sun-dried tomatoes. These are just so good. People, I just love sun-dried tomatoes. Again, they are more yin. Again, the same thing that I said about the tomato sauce, about the avocados. You know, you gotta, things are gonna change, and you gotta adjust. You gotta bend the rules to better fit, you know, what's happening. You know, you can't stay the same. That's the problem. If you stay the same, you know, you got to change. You got to be flexible. And then I got two seasonings. This one, this is like a staple when I make tacos. I make, I always have like beans, you know, to go in the tacos. But I always make, I need to update my taco recipe. Because I have a video where I made vegan tacos, but I've updated. That was like when I first started eating like plant-based. But I've updated a lot, girl, and it's so much better. But I make like a stir fry with corn, carrots, cabbage, onions, and I season it. Tastes so good, so good to put in the tacos. And this is a key ingredient. So I ran out of it. I never ran out of a spice before. Never. I just always had a million of them that I only have like this much gone or something. But this I ran out of, girl. What's that telling you? The chili lime seasoning. Get it. And they have it displayed next to like the watermelon and the mango because, you know, it's a popular like Mexican, you know, South American, you know, treat to put this on, you know, tropical fruits. Which you can do that, girl, if you want to. It's up to you. But I just put it on my thing for my tacos. And then this, the red chili pepper, crushed red chili pepper. I got this because my boyfriend and I, we go to a lot of different vegan restaurants, and there's this one where they always have like creative kind of soups. And they had this one that was broccoli avocado soup. And we tried it, and it was kind of spicy, and we're like, I mean, my boyfriend and I don't really like a lot of spice, but it was kind of cool, and the guy said it was red pepper in there. So I thought, I mean, maybe if I want to make that, I can. I have avocados, but I just thought, and I also saw different recipes, you know, lately using red pepper. So I wanted to try, you know, with a little bit of red pepper. Not too much, because I'm not really into that, but just a little bit, you know, for something different. And then, oh, this is really cool. It's this garlic spread dip. and it's vegan. And I've gotten similar dips like this before, but they just never had them at Trader Joe's. But it was cool, you know, they have this at Trader Joe's because I used to only be able to find it at like the independent health food store. But now that Trader Joe's has a version, so it's basically, I mean, the first ingredient is like canola oil, which is probably like the worst oil. And then it's garlic, lemon juice, citric acid, salt. So it's not the best, but it's something different, you know, to dip your vegetables in so you're not suffering eating bland vegetables. Girl, you don't have to suffer. If you want to eat healthy, you don't have to suffer, girl. There's ways to make your food taste good so you can continue eating healthy, you know? And then, butter lettuce to eat salads, because I've been eating salads. And then some cutlery that I swiped. And then I got some organic Persian cucumbers. I really been liking lately to slice these and put them inside my water bottle. So it's like cucumber water. I've never been that kind of person that, let me put lemon in my water. I put cucumber. But there's a day spa that I like to go to, and it's just such a cool place. I just love that place. Oh my God. I just love that place so much. Like, I want to go there. I want to live there. That's how much I love that place. It's just so amazing. But anyways, and their prices are not that crazy. Most day spas are like obnoxious prices, you know, and that's why only like rich white ladies can go there. But this one is like more like, you know, reasonable. And they have a lot of cool things happening. But anyways, they had a thing of, I think they put cucumbers and lemon in there. And so one time I went there, and after my session, I drank the water, and it was so good. So I started doing that. I started putting lemon and cucumber in my water. So it was like refreshing. I don't know, something different. And then at the end, you could just eat the little cucumber that's left. Cool. And then I got organic broccoli florets. You know, staple vegetable for me. Another staple, organic Tuscan kale. And lately, you know what's weird, people? Lately, I've just been steaming it and eating it like that. Like, I actually like it like that. Who am I? I don't know. A brand new beagle queen. New and improved. Okay, these. I used to get these all the time when I was in high school. And I just had a craving lately for them. And they're the dried flattened bananas. These are amazing, people. Again, if you're like really into macrobiotics, bananas are like, don't eat bananas, girl. You know, it's a tropical fruit. It's made for people who live in a tropical environment because it's so yin, it cools you off. If you live, you know, in North America, you know, it's not really meant for you, girl. It doesn't grow naturally, you know. But, like I said about the tomatoes and the avocado, you know. Plus, I don't really follow all the rules or, you know, all the, you know, guidelines of macrobiotic eating, you know, to a T. I don't do that because to me that feels too restrictive. Right now, maybe in like 30 years I might be able to do that. But right now I can't do that. It's not comfortable for me. So, you know. Bananas, it's fine, girl. Once in a while, it's fine. It's fine, girl. And then, people. Okay, I've been obsessed with mandarin oranges lately. I was obsessed with those Cara Cara oranges, which I haven't seen. I haven't been seeing those, and I'm so sad because those were my favorite fruit. But then I was with my boyfriend at the farmer's market, and we tried samples, and the vendor had oranges, Cara Cara, and mandarin, and they were so good. And my boyfriend just bought a few of each, and I was like obsessed with them because they were all really good. So I think they're all in season right now, probably. But you know, at Trader Joe's, they stopped carrying the Caracara, so they might not be in season anymore. So then I just was like, oh, but I really wanted them. I'll just get the mandarins because, you know, I remembered last time at the farmer's market, they were really good. So they're in season, so they're probably good. And I got them and I was eating like so bad. Well, depending on how you look at it, but I was eating like one a day, two on Friday, which was yesterday. I ate three or four. I ate a lot. And again, oranges is another kind of fruit, you know, macrobiotics that they kind of like advise don't indulge in too often. But I'm just like, I'm under a lot of stress. Okay, it's hot. I want it. And it's not as bad as sugar. See, that's how I justify a lot of things. It's not as bad as sugar. You know, like when your parents, you know, get mad at you for stuff and you're like, I could be a drug addict. Okay. You know? So, these are really good. Look how many oranges are in there. So good. And plus, I've been really just craving. This is the main craving I've been getting. Like that sweetness, juiciness, coolness of fruit. That's what I've been craving. More than anything else, that's what I've been craving. Craving watermelon, craving strawberries, craving mandarin oranges. Just like, because I just want that coolness, that sweetness, that juiciness. And how amazing that Mother Nature provides that for us in many shapes and colors and textures. So great. But anyway, speaking of, the last thing I got, da-da-da-da, what is this? I'm scared, but anyways, last thing I got is a mini watermelon. Yay, so excited. But anyways, that's everything I got from Trader Joe's today. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Thanks for watching. Later, haters, and also...